Hi, today's topic is Dauphin Island and 7 reasons why you must visit here now. I talk about travel and life as an author. Please subscribe if this interests you. Today's topic is Dauphin Island. Affectionately called the unluckiest island in America, compared to Earth's other endangered spaces like the Glacier National Park, Dauphin Island hides its secrets close to its chest. When you step into the island, your imagination can smell the gunpowder from the Civil War. Feel it in the swells of the air that this place has seen and endured. An island unlike any other we had been to before. Here is why you too should experience its uniqueness. First reason, history and Fort Gaines. Damn the torpedoes are the famous words sculpted into the walls of Fort Gaines. French Louisiana's territory's capital, ruled by so many nations, French, British, Spanish, the island has seen the vessels of slaves docking at its harbors, the U.S. Navy winning the Civil War against the Confederate ships at sea, the soldiers treading its cobbled paths during World War II, repeatedly battered by hurricanes that have threatened its existence. Stories ring from its shores. Hurricane Katrina destroyed 450 of the 500 homes off the West End, 16 years after Hurricane Frederic destroyed the bridge connecting it to mainland. Now, with a fancy rebuilt bridge and new homes, the island symbolizes resilience. Our newly built modern rental had fresh wood, smell intact, overlooking the bridge and the quieter north side of the island. Away from the strip, an elementary school slows the traffic, the vegetation thickens, giant trees sprawl the landscape, rekindling the memory of greenery known to Hawaii. For Fort Gaines, reserve an hour. Ferries run between Fort Gaines and Fort Watkin on the other side of the bay. Second reason is wildlife and Audubon Bird Sanctuary. Dauphin Island provides first stop, rest stop for birds crossing the ocean. Why it has so many bird sanctuaries? On one evening, rain and wind slapped both shores, sealing us at home over a Kahoot game and lavish dinner, when the pelicans swooped and sailed over the turbulent sea. They seemed so comfortable in the arms of the storm. We visited the Audubon Bird Sanctuary in another evening to gain more steps. A rooster greeted us at the well-shaded parking lot and trail. Though we didn't catch an alligator, we spotted bright lemony birds and countless turtles in the lake. The prevalent serenity grows a prayer in your heart and calms your spirit. The trail leads to a south-facing beach where my children's unfettered enthusiasm broke into high jumps, tall sandy mounds, deep canyons, and endless giggles. And I discovered my second book's title as my fingers bowed to the evening sun and wrote House of Milk and Cheese on the Sand. You can walk across the trails in a half hour, but I recommend an hour or two here to relax. I understand now why the residents and the mayor is protective of this oasis. We too can protect Dauphin Island's vulnerable shores by reducing our footprint on the environment and slowing down the raging oceans. Third reason to visit here is its origin and the Indian Shell Mound Park. Did you know Dauphin Island was once called the Massacre Island? When the founder of French Louisiana Territory first discovered the island, he stumbled across skeletons and named it the Massacre Island. But not a bloodbath, a Mississippian burial mound had broken open from a hurricane. So they rightly renamed the island to Dauphin, which not only rhymes with dolphin, it means dolphin in French after Louis XIV's descendant. Nonetheless, the Native American burial ground remains on the island. I didn't see any teepees or graves, but the park provided another pristine 15-minute walk through the woods. 4. Escape and the pristine white sands. To sink your feet into the powdery white sand and leave an imprint, to walk solo uninterrupted for miles, to not sling shoulders or deflect smoke from a crowd partying on a beach leaves you with a strange sense of ownership. It's like you own the sand beneath your feet, the breeze on your face, the trees, the pelicans swooping on the water, and the cargo ships sailing into the horizon. The solitude at an island where you can see both sides of the ocean can tear into a spirit, weigh you down with a deep sense of loneliness, and leave you with hours to dwell on life. Experience it and you will meet yourself on the other side. Next reason is flowers and the Pellengriff Gardens. While Dauphin Islands provides relaxation from the burnt out, overworked existence I and my husband lead, the gardens at the mouth of the island sprinkle a dash of sweetness. On the first day, we checked out Fort Gaines in the morning, followed by this stop. I learned that Pellengriff was the first Coca-Cola bottler in the area. He has left behind his mansion featuring fancy china that we didn't see from the inside, but the gardens delight with the foul river, bamboo trees, lakes, and endless sprays of color. 2 hours fit neatly here, though you can spend the entire day. The leisure stroll will make you hungry, so plan accordingly. 6. Food and Mobile, Alabama. You can't miss Mobile if visiting Dauphin. USS Alabama, the plazas for Spain, UK, Dauphin Street, Church, the fountains, and Emerald Parks are a hallmark of Mobile. It's possible to see all this in one day. USS Alabama, which features a warship and the submarine, requires at a minimum 2 to 3 hours. When at Dauphin Street, try the cappuccino and mango smoothie from Serda Coffee and blackened chicken Alfredo from Wenzel's Oyster House. Food options are endless in Mobile. If in the mood for Indian, biryani pot didn't disappoint. Their dal and biryani were good. Lastly, location, location, location. Dauphin Island's location is an ideal distance away from Mobile, Bahamahenge and the surrounding sculptures, as well as Montgomery and New Orleans. To plan day trips, the island runs east to west, which allows for laid-back sunset and sunrise lining each side of the day, no matter the destination in between. So visit this gem. I leave you with a few tips if you do make it here. A gas station and a series of restaurants are present on the island, but check their hours as the island exudes a laid-back culture. You can find simple items like pizza and black coffee in the evening, but the breakfast places with specialty warm beverages shut early. Before taking the ferry, please check their Facebook page. They can quite frequently cancel rides owing to weather or inspections, but we made it on our third attempt after confirming online. The ferry accommodates about 18 cars on a first-come, first-served basis, arrive 20 to 30 minutes early at a minimum. That's all I have on Dauphin Island today. Next time, we travel to Montgomery. Also, my book, House of Milk and Cheese, is coming out on May 22nd. I hope you can join the launch party and win the raffle. Stay tuned here or on my website at www.bookofdreams.us for more details. Hi, please subscribe to this video on YouTube and stay connected with me. Please.